There's a laugh and a drink and a couch and a shrink and a moment to think and a wish I had a pocket full of gold. So throw your sticks and throw your stones, 'cause you ain't gonna break my bones. If I'm a sinner,
you're all doing good. I hope you enjoyed that little clip of me putting out my strawberries. I'm just gonna give a quick little description of like why I'm doing this, why I did this project, and then I'm gonna show you the clues of what I gave everybody else on my social media platforms, and then I'll kind of summarize it at the end after that. So this idea came to me once this whole corona thing happened and I had to move back home. Just because I was trying to think of an idea of how, like, we can still be a community and commune together, but separately. And so I was thinking about Setu Jones and the kind of projects he does. And this came to me, strawberries, I've used in my work before. It's a reference to J.R.R. Tolkien in his last book of the Lord of the Rings trilogy. He has a, there's a quote that Samwise Gamgee says to Frodo when they're climbing the hill. Frodo's about to give up and climbing the hill. They're climbing Mount Doom, you know, it's a big deal. Samwise kind of has this little monologue basically saying, don't forget about home. Don't forget about why we're doing this. Remember the fresh taste of strawberries. It's just kind of about the importance of home and remembering where you came from. And so I just really like that metaphor. So I thought this was appropriate still for this community sort of project of just kind of remembering home, even though we're in this weird time, like remember the places that kind of built us and stuff. So all these strawberries are placed in, you know, iconic places sort of in my hometown, and I'll go through those now and give you the little clues to or what I did. Some of these might not make sense to you, but the people who live in Spring Arbor know what these clues mean and what I'm referencing in these. So this was at Frosty Boy. The clue was, soon we will gather here and enjoy some fresh strawberries with a frozen treat. So this is where I worked in high school. It is a very popular spot in my hometown. Everybody loves it. And this was the picture I posted so that they could all see. And then this was at Gallagher Park. There are two soccer fields, or there's many soccer fields, two softball, baseball fields that people can use. And very packed on the weekends in the summer. This is, the clue was, when the weather warms up, let's meet here for a ball game. And so you saw I hid it in the tree, but this was the picture, so hopefully they had a look a bit. This was at my grandmother's grave. Did have permission for this. The clue was a little more specific for this one. We come here to remember, to pay respect to those we've lost. Follow the path, and you will find Gladi Galogli. So I hope the picture gave a little more reference, and then same with the clue. But luckily, her gravestone is right on the path. You don't have to walk far into the cemetery. And then this is Mount Beebe, a popular sledding hill. Well, the only sledding hill in my town. The clue was, today it's about the climb, but when there's more snow, it's all about the descent. So these clues aren't like super tricky, hopefully, but somewhat helpful. This one was not hidden, just right on top of the hill. It is the one that went missing, though. And then the oak, this clue was... this clue was, you will find this one within SAU's oldest mascot. So this was the picture, but I also took this picture so that you could see like where I placed it. Wasn't just like on the ground. Hopefully everybody... Yeah, because it's a popular walking area. So I wanted it to be somewhat... off the path. This was at the one room schoolhouse. Clue was, if your grandma went to elementary school in Spring Arbor, she may have climbed these steps. So as you saw, I hid them in the steps, but this was the picture that I put, and you know, people would have had to kind of look for it a bit. And then I put one at Clock Tower. This was check under the four pillars. So you saw in the video, there's like four pillars. It's a very famous spot in Spring Arbor. Everybody kind of knows those four pillars. I hope you kind of noticed I put it under the pillar of experience. Just a little shout out to our class. And then you're about to see some pictures that people actually did it. I did not know anyone did it until literally right before I was about to make this video. This is from a couple that they looked really familiar, you know, to me, but I had to ask my mom who they were. But they took their grandkids out and found my strawberries. And they did put this one back. They did not steal it. This was at the cemetery. I don't know if they found all the pictures. They only posted these few. Or found all the strawberries. They only posted a few pictures. But I'm glad somebody did it. But I am going to do it again when the weather is warmer. But I'm glad they had fun. Hey, so. I'm glad somebody enjoyed it and they were able to use it. I will do it again when it is nice out. So that hopefully more people can participate and we will have been locked inside longer. And I think people will be going a little stir crazy if they aren't already. So I put the hashtag on the back of the strawberries. I forgot to take a picture of that, but it is there along with all the posts that I made about it. So I thought, I hope people would know that they could use the hashtag if they wanted to. And how I could keep track and it would form that like community just through the internet. I did also put my name on the back so that it would hopefully make it a little more personal and deter anyone from who's wanting to steal it maybe. The one did get stolen from Mount Beebe. I expected at least one to go, so it wasn't that surprising. That location was surprising, I guess, just because I didn't think it would get a lot of foot traffic when there's no snow on the ground, but it is what it is. And it did help putting my name on the back, help people recognize if they didn't know what it was. I did have somebody who like saw strawberry, but didn't know like what it was for. And then later told me they saw strawberry with my name on it. And so I'm glad it works that way as well. I just want to tell you, I made them out of MDF board, and then yeah, cut them out, painted them, and then put sealant on them so that they stayed out two nights and were not damaged by the rain or snow that happened over the weekend. So that was great. But like I said, I think I'm gonna try it again. And I'll let you know how that goes. So I hope you're all doing well, and I'll see you when I see ya.